Hello, I'm Dr. Ailey Kalapilla from Emory University. In this National HIV Curriculum mini-lecture, I will provide a summary of the antiretroviral medication Maraviroc. Maraviroc is an antiretroviral drug that is part of a class of drugs called entry inhibitors. It is only available as an oral formulation, either tablets or an oral solution. The drug has to be taken twice daily, and it may be taken with or without food. Maraviroc is indicated in combination with other antiretroviral agents for the treatment of only CCR5 tropic HIV type 1 infection in adult and pediatric patients weighing at least 2 kilos. CCR5 is a viral coreceptor found on CD4 lymphocytes. So R5 tropic HIV means virus that only binds to CCR5 and does not bind to other viral coreceptors. All patients should be screened for HIV tropism prior to initiating Maraviroc. Maraviroc is typically used as part of a salvage regimen. So this means that it is a regimen that is used when an individual has failed more conventional combination antiretroviral therapies. As such, it is not recommended as a first-line agent for the treatment of HIV. As mentioned in the previous slide, Maraviroc can only be administered orally, either as a tablet or an oral solution, and it is dosed twice a day. So this is a table demonstrating changes in dosing of Maraviroc when administered simultaneously with drugs that either inhibit or induce cytochrome P450. As you can see, the standard dosage is 300 mg twice daily. However, the dose should be decreased to 150 mg twice a day if drugs given concomitantly are strong cytochrome P450 inhibitors. If the drugs administered concomitantly are strong cytochrome P450 inducers, then the dose of Maraviroc will need to be increased to 600 mg twice daily. This table shows the dosing of Maraviroc based on renal function and concomitant medications. Next, I'm going to delve into more detail on the mechanism of action for Maraviroc. HIV enters a host cell by a complex process that involves first the attachment to CD4 T lymphocyte receptors, followed by binding to a viral coreceptor on the host cell. There are two types of coreceptors, CCR5 and CXCR4. The type of coreceptor recognized by HIV will determine the type of CD4 host cell that the virus can infect. HIV that binds only to CCR5 is known as R5 tropic virus. HIV that binds only to CXCR4 is called X4 tropic. If HIV binds to both receptors, it is described as dual tropic. Finally, the presence of R5 tropic, X4 tropic, and/or dual tropic virus together in one host is referred to as mixed tropic virus. Tropism assays are used to determine the coreceptor tropism of the patient's dominant virus population. The important point to note here is that Maraviroc, because it works as a CCR5 antagonist, can only be used on pure R5 tropic virus. Now, this slide shows a more detailed mechanism of action for Maraviroc. Essentially, Maraviroc selectively binds to the CCR5 coreceptor on the host cell. By doing this, it induces a conformational change that effectively blocks HIV envelope glycoprotein GP120 from binding to the CCR5 coreceptor. Now that you know the mechanism of action of Maraviroc, you can hopefully understand why Maraviroc can only be used in patients with R5 tropic virus. Because if an individual has X4 tropic, dual, or mixed tropic virus, then Maraviroc is useless since the virus will shift to using the CXCR4 receptor to infect host cells. Now, we will discuss notable clinical trials studying Maraviroc use in combination antiretroviral regimens. In antiretroviral treatment-naive individuals, the MERIT study compared Maraviroc to efavirenz, both with a zidovudine-lamivudine NRTI backbone, in patients with pure R5 tropic virus. The results from the study demonstrated that Maraviroc was inferior to efavirenz for virologic suppression. The MOTIVATE 1 and 2 studies were conducted in antiretroviral treatment experienced patients, and they compared the efficacy and tolerability of Maraviroc in combination with optimized background therapy with placebo. The study reported that Maraviroc, when given in combination with optimized background therapy, resulted in greater virologic suppression compared to optimized background therapy alone. Rock and RAL was a study done in antiretroviral treatment-experienced patients. This was a single-arm study that enrolled patients who had viral suppression and clinical lipohypertrophy. The study enrollees were switched from their suppressive antiretroviral regimen to Maraviroc plus raltegravir. The study was prematurely discontinued when it became clear that several study participants had developed virological failure on the Maraviroc plus raltegravir combination regimen. Approval of Maraviroc for treatment-experienced individuals was based on results from the MOTIVATE 1 and 2 studies. These studies were conducted in parallel and were randomized double-blind placebo-controlled phase 3 trials. They enrolled highly treatment-experienced patients with R5 tropic HIV, and all participants had resistance to at least one agent from each of three major antiretroviral drug classes. In both studies, all the participants were provided with background therapy, which was optimized based on resistance testing. The study subjects were then randomized to one of three groups. They got either placebo, or once daily dose of 300 mg of Maraviroc, or twice daily Maraviroc dosed at 150 mg. Results on viral suppression indicated that significantly more patients receiving once or twice daily Maraviroc had HIV RNA levels of less than 50 copies per ml compared to the placebo group. Results on CD4 count showed that study participants receiving once or twice daily Maraviroc experienced a greater rise in their CD4 lymphocyte counts from their baseline CD4 counts compared to those in the placebo arm. This table shows the adverse effects noted in all three arms of the studies. As you can see, there were no significant differences in the rates of treatment-related adverse events between the placebo, once-daily Maraviroc, and twice-daily Maraviroc groups. Now, we will discuss some of the adverse effects associated with Maraviroc use. In general, Maraviroc is a fairly well-tolerated drug with few side effects. That being said, there are some notable severe reactions that one should be aware of, including hepatotoxicity, a severe skin rash, or systemic allergic reactions. Maraviroc carries a black box warning regarding hepatotoxicity. The hepatotoxicity may be preceded by systemic allergic symptoms such as itchy rash, fever, or eosinophilia. Typically, such reactions will occur within 1 month of Maraviroc initiation. If these symptoms occur, the patient should have an urgent clinical evaluation with their healthcare provider. Now, we will review principles of resistance to Maraviroc. Now, Maraviroc is unique in that developing resistance or virologic breakthrough can occur via two mechanisms. The first mechanism is by emergence of X4 tropic virus, and this can happen in two different ways while on Maraviroc treatment. The first is by expansion of pre-existing X4 tropic virus that was not previously detected before Maraviroc was initiated. Now, this is the most common reason why virologic failure may occur while taking Maraviroc. The other way is when certain mutations develop in the HIV envelope glycoprotein GP120 that cause a de novo tropism switch. It is usually recommended to repeat an HIV tropism assay whenever an individual experiences virologic failure on Maraviroc. The second mechanism of Maraviroc resistance can occur independently of any changes to HIV tropism, and it involves mutations in GP120, which allows the R5 tropic HIV to bind to CCR5 despite the presence of Maraviroc. So in summary, Maraviroc belongs to a class of drugs that are HIV entry inhibitors. It is an oral regimen dosed twice a day. It works by acting as a CCR5 antagonist and prevents binding of HIV to the host cell. Because it only binds to the CCR5 coreceptor, the drug should only be used in individuals who have R5 tropic virus, as opposed to X4, dual, or mixed tropic virus. So all patients should undergo an HIV tropism assay if Maraviroc is being considered for use in their combination antiretroviral regimen. Maraviroc is not recommended as a first-line agent for use in combination antiretroviral regimens. It is recommended for use in salvage regimens among treatment-experienced individuals who are experiencing virologic failure with commonly used antiretroviral drugs. Maraviroc can be used in combination with other HIV entry inhibitors. In general, it is a well-tolerated medication with few side effects or drug interactions. Rarely, Maraviroc can cause severe hepatotoxicity, skin rashes, or systemic allergic reactions.
The production of this National HIV Curriculum Mini-Lecture was supported by funding from the Health Resources and Services Administration.